Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss integration of rational functions using partial fractions. The example we have is to evaluate the indefinite integral of x squared plus x plus 2, all divided by x cubed minus 16x. Let's go ahead and carefully work through this problem solution. First thing you want to do is try to factor the denominator. So notice that x cubed minus 16x, you can actually pull out an x here. So this is x parentheses x squared minus 16. And then you can factor the second piece as the difference of squares. So it's x, x minus 4, x plus 4. Right? That's x squared minus 4 squared. So it's x minus 4, x plus 4. Pretty easy factoring. So now what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite our integrand. But I'm going to write it in factored form. I'm going to replace the bottom, x cubed minus 16x, with x, x minus 4, x plus 4. So we have x squared plus x plus 2 over, and then we have x, x minus 4, x plus 4. And now we're going to set up what's called the partial fraction decomposition. We have linear factors, so we just use a constant. So it's a over x, and then plus, and then b over x minus 4, and then plus, and then c over x plus 4. So we have set up the partial fraction decomposition. So because we have x, x minus 4, and x plus 4, you just write constants in front of you, on top of each. All right, so now we have to solve for a, b, and c. So what we're going to do is we're basically going to multiply both sides by x, x minus 4, x plus 4. So I'm going to write down what we're going to do up here in a different color because it's going to help us. Watch. We're going to multiply by, and again, we're multiplying by x, x minus 4, x plus 4. You can certainly write it on both sides of the equation, but a lot of times there's no room. So on the left-hand side, it's going to go away. In fact, I'll go ahead and write it. Why not? I have room. So you see it. So putting it on both sides. So on this side, we have x, x minus 4, x plus 4. It's really over 1, so this cancels. So we have x squared plus x plus 2. And on the right-hand side, again, we're multiplying by this on the right-hand side. So I guess I'll go ahead and write it again. Okay, and we're going to distribute. So let's think about that. So we have a over x times x, x minus 4, x plus 4. So the x's will cancel. So we're left with a, x minus 4, x plus 4. Right? Because the x will cancel. For the b over x minus 4, the x minus 4 will cancel. So we're left with b times x times x plus 4. And for the c, the x plus 4 cancels, so we're left with x, x minus 4. Now what we're going to do is we're going to plug in values for x to find a, b, and c. So what values are we going to plug in? Values that make things go away. For example, if I plug in 4, the a is going to go away. So let's do that. So when x is 4, on the left-hand side, we get 4 squared. Plus 4 plus 2. On the right hand side, when you plug in a 4 here for the x, you get 4 minus 4, so the whole thing is 0. Same thing with the c, you would get 4 minus 4 at the end here, and it would be 0. So you're left with b times 4 times 8, because 4 plus 4 is 8. This implies that the left hand side is going to give us 16 plus 4, which is 20, so 22, equals 4 times 8 is 32b. Divide by 32, divide by 32. So B ends up being 22 over 32, so that's going to be 11 over 16. I'm going to put it in a box because that's an accomplishment, right? It takes a bit of work to find the constants A, B, and C. By the way, there's other ways to do this problem. This is just one way to do it. So X equals negative 4. Plugging in negative 4, I pick negative 4 because it'll make the B go away, right? It'll make the B go away because we have negative 4 plus 4 when I put an X there. So we have negative 4 squared. And then X is negative 4, so minus 4 plus 2 equals. The A will also go away because it has an X plus 4 term. And so negative 4 plus 4 is 0. So that's gone. The A's gone. The B's gone. The only thing that's left is the C. So we have negative 4. And then negative 4 minus 4. So the left-hand side is going to be 16. Then minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2 equals. This is going to be C times negative 4 times negative 8. Well, look at that. It's going to be 32 again. So we get 14 equals 32C. And then dividing by 32, we're going to get C equals 14 over 32. Which is going to be 7/16. So I'm going to write it again, and I'm going to put it in a box. I'll write it in yellow. C is equal to 7 over 16, and I'll put it in a box. Really good to have it identified. The last number we can plug in that will make things go away is 0. So let's do that. So X equals 0. This time on the left-hand side, the X squared plus X plus 2, it's going to be easier. It'll just be 0 squared plus 0 plus 2. So we'll just get 2. On the right-hand side, the B will go away because you get B times 0, and that's 0. Same thing with the C. You'll get C times 0. So we're just left with the A term. It'll be A, 0 minus 4, so negative 4, 0 plus 4, so 4. This implies that 2 is equal to negative 16A. So dividing by negative 16, we get A equals negative 2 over 16. And that means that A is equal to negative 1 over 8. And I'm also going to put that in a box. Beautiful. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take the A, B, and C, and we're going to plug them back into A over X plus B over X minus 4 plus C over X plus 4. And then we're just going to integrate that, right? Because that's what our original integral is going to be equal to because we rewrote it, right? So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to write it down here again so you see it. So we have A over X, and then we have plus B over X minus 4, and then we have plus C over X plus 4. And A is negative 1/8, so you get negative 1/8, but no one puts it on the top. People, what people do is they put it on the front, like this. Negative 1/8 times 1 over X. And then B was 11 over 16. So instead of putting it up top, just put it in the front. So 11 over 16, it's the same thing algebraically. And then C was 7/16. So plus 7/16, 1 over X plus 4. And basically, we're integrating all this. I'm just going to put parentheses around it. I'll put a dx here, and I'll put the integral sign. And these are easy integrals. They're all going to give you natural logs. Whenever you integrate 1 over x, you get ln absolute value of x. So this is negative 1/8 ln absolute value of x. Usually the integrals you get are easy. This one here is the same. You can make a u sub if you wanted to. You could let u equal x minus 4, and du is dx. So it's just going to give you plus 11/16 natural log absolute value x minus 4. Same thing on the last one, 7/16. Natural log absolute value x plus 4. Technically, you're supposed to do a u sub, but you know when you get to a certain point, and maybe this is that point, you don't really bother with it because it's so easy, and the problems themselves are so complicated, as you can see. So, but yeah, the one formula we used here was the fact that the integral of 1 over x dx, again, is equal to the natural log of the absolute value of x plus c. And for the last two terms, we did have to do a u sub, but we skipped it because if we would have done it, it wouldn't have changed the answer anyways. Wow, what a problem. Partial fractions take a long time to do. These problems are easy to mess up on, so just take your time and do your best. I hope this video has been helpful, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.